If expectations for this Twins team this season are high, tonight's first exhibition game does nothing to deter that optimism. I'm Eric Perkins. Welcome to the Care 11 Sports Extra from Fort Myers, where we've been covering the Twins all week long here as they get ready for the upcoming season. And tonight in their first exhibition game, they look really impressive, whipping up on the Golden Gophers. It's pros against collegians tonight here at Hammond Stadium. Rocco Baldelli welcoming U of M head coach John Anderson, a chance for the fans in attendance to get a good glimpse at some of the Twins' brightest emerging stars, including one of the top prospects in all of baseball, Royce Lewis, who comes out swinging in the first, lacing one off the left field fence. Lewis scores 3 runs in the game, more than enough for this Twins pitching staff. Randy Dobnak, 2 scoreless with 4 strikeouts. Trevor May and Tyler Duffy also with scoreless frames in this one. Gophers managing just 1 hit this entire game. Floodgates open. Twins win it 16-0. They call the game after 7 innings. Gophers come home actually tonight and will play their home opener tomorrow at U.S. Bank Stadium against TCU. The Twins begin their Grapefruit League schedule now and travel to Bradenton tomorrow to face the Pittsburgh Pirates. The Twins' big free agent offseason acquisition, of course, was Josh Donaldson. And when he's not crushing home runs over the center field fence in batting practice, he's usually conferring or collaborating with teammates, trying every day to get this Twins team better.
My goals for the season it's very simple. I want to give my team a chance to win each and every day. I want to start off accomplishing one goal, which is to do one thing a day to help my team win. Once I do one, then I can move to the second.
And that's just who he is. I think, you know, he goes home at night, he watches baseball. He wakes up in the morning, he watches baseball. It's what he loves. And it's probably the reason why he continues to push himself and learn and you know, now teach.
The other big bopper on this team, of course, is the DH, Nelson Cruz, who is back for another season, and we're happy about that. Cruz is now the 4th oldest player in all of Major League Baseball, and if you're wondering how he keeps up the amazing pace that he's on, well, a lot of it has to do with his health. And he hired his cousin, actually, David Cruz, from the Dominican Republic, to be his personal chef a few years ago. We caught up with Cruz in his kitchen this morning as David cooked him breakfast and then cooked lunch for the entire team.
Oh, he is healthy.
Did the egg organic.
I mean, like I said, we can eat healthy right now. Maybe the season, we need more calories. And when we're in a row, I mean, it's kind of more difficult.
Learn with my mom and my family. For 2.5 hours.
This is a huge part of maintain your body, so your body can be healthy. A combination of tools to get all the pieces together. He did this last year during the season. It was awesome. I think that's why we hit a lot of bombas.
The guys say, oh my God, David coming with the food. It's my favorite food. And I feel happy.
Best part of my day. The best chef in the world, I can say that.
and I can say that I can attest it was really, really good food, and it's no wonder Nelson Cruz remains in as good a shape as he's in. Plenty more to come on the Care 11 Sports Extra, including a look at the next generation of Twin stars. Plus, our own Andy Mack goes deep undercover, as it were, and a fun game with the Minnesota Twins players. It's not the ball and bucket challenge. We're taking it to the next level. That's next. All right, this year's Twins team has the potential to be so good, as we know. But what's even more encouraging is that the future looks as bright. These farm system players coming up in the pipeline look really good, and a lot of those guys are here at spring training in Fort Myers. Guys like outfielder Alex Kirilloff, last year's Twins Minor League Player of the Year, Trevor Larnach, and then one of the most highly anticipated minor leaguers in the game period, Royce Lewis.
Yeah, I think the rankings are a little bit BS. I think if anything, it just helps me because the fans have backing for a player like that has a higher potential, I guess. But otherwise, I look at everyone the same. I mean, we're all fighting for the same thing, is to get to be a big leaguer. And, you know, we all got to put in the same work.
Just kind of absorb as much knowledge as possible. And, you know, at the same time, I want to compete and I want to, you know, play the best that I can as well.
Being a Minnesota Twin, it's something that you can't really describe because you look around the locker room, you see how many dudes and how many special players you have around here. So just to be around that alone, it's very special, and I'm very thankful for that.
Kind of fun to watch those guys. One fellow who isn't on any top 100 prospect lists is our own Andy McDonald. And yet, oddly enough, in and around Fort Myers this week, many times he has been mistaken for a big league player. And I'm not kidding about that. So I decided to take it to the next level and just see what would happen if we disguised him as a Minnesota Twin. Here from Fort Myers, let's see if we can fool some people. Right now, I'm Andy Mack, sports reporter. Next, I'm Andy Mack, big leaguer. Let's go. Woo! Let's go.
Can I get a picture?
Sure, of course.
Thank you.
Of course.
Thank you.
Yeah, he'll pass.
Got the Royce Lewis approval. Let's go. Josh Donaldson dropped some bombs. I'm up next. I think, honestly, I put the gear on, I felt like the part. Yeah, I got a little bit. Yeah. I'm not quite like you, but I still got it. I gotta find a nickname. That's what I need. You got a nickname. I need a nickname. That's how we do it in the
big leagues.
¿Cómo estás? Bien?
Bien, bien, bien.
Bien, bien. It was great. A lot of work.
No.
A lot of fun.
A lot of fun.
Of course, my man. Enjoy it. Go Twins.
Thank you.
Of course. You. Pleasing the fans. That's what it's about. He kept the hat, too, FYI. Hey, one of the Care 11 spring training traditions I've established a few years ago was the ball and bucket challenge. This year, I changed up the rules. It's actually the closest to the bat challenge.
What are we winning?
You're winning the bat. It's a Kyle Gibson bat, man.
I've asked you in the past to toss it in the bucket.
Uh-oh, where's the bucket at?
I need you to throw this ball. You can try to get as close to the bat as possible. If you hit the bat, it's nullified.
Nullify.
Yeah. It's a Kyle Gibson bat, for what that's worth.
Should be pretty easy to miss it then.
As I promise. Okay, that's pretty doggone good. I think we've got a new leader.
Can I roll it?
Yeah, you can roll it. Yeah, yeah.
Can I roll it?
Yeah, sure. I don't even know how to rule on that.
I mean, it's not terrible.
So far, the clubhouse leader is Kenta Maeda.
Oh, boy.
He was about 5 inches away, I'm not going to lie. He was pretty close.
Oh, goodness.
I mean, if you nestle it up there nicely, you could win this whole thing. Rosario. not bad.
I hit it. Oh!
Too much.
Respectable. It's got a chance.
We got a win.
Let's go.
We got a
let's go with that.
Good night, everybody. We're coming home. See ya.